Welcome to the demonstration of Tzunami Deployer. During this demonstration, we will perform a migration from SharePoint 2007 to SharePoint 2010 using Tzunami Deployer. This presentation will go over the four main steps of the migration process. First, we will connect to our source, SharePoint 2007, and load the source content. Next, we will repeat this process to load our target, SharePoint 2010. We will then perform the virtual deployment along with all of its relevant configurations. And finally, we will commit our migration specifications to the target SharePoint 2010. We will start by creating a new Deployer project. When we click on File, New, Deployer will create a new project for us to work on. We are prompted to give our project a name. We'll call it SharePoint Demo. Next, we'll specify the project folder using the Browse button. We'll now choose our source and target systems from the list. For this demo, we'll choose to deploy from SharePoint 2007 and deploy to our target, SharePoint 2010. Our new project is now ready for migration. As you can see, a Deployer project is divided into two areas. The top area is for the source content, in our case, the content that will be loaded from SharePoint 2007, and the bottom area is for the target SharePoint 2010. In the source panel of Deployer, we'll load the data from our source, SharePoint 2007. This is done by clicking the Connect button on top, or by right-clicking the source panel and then Connect to SharePoint. We now have the connection wizard. When we click Next, we are required to specify the connection details. First, we will fill in our server address. This can be done by entering the server's name or IP address. To make sure you have the correct information, please consult with your system administrator. Next, we enter our credentials. The user connecting to SharePoint must have sufficient privileges in order for Deployer to write the changes to SharePoint. Please refer to our Tzunami Deployer user guide for more information regarding permissions. After the connection to the SharePoint server was made, we choose which web applications we would like to load into our project. We are now able to decide how we would like to load our SharePoint structure. It is recommended to load the minimum amount of content required for your specific migration project. First, we choose which site collections we wish to load to our project. When the Read Subsites option is checked, Deployer will read all subsites under the site collection. Under the Content tab, we can choose to read none of the lists, only the libraries, or all of the lists. The same applies for reading items. We can read none of the items, the latest version only, or all versions. When no sites and no lists are selected, the loading process is expedited and we are able to reload any content from our SharePoint target panel at any time. Under Additional Content, we choose whether we would like to read web parts and navigation information from the source pages. Please note that if the Read Web Parts from Pages option is unchecked, Deployer will skip reading the web parts and will not be able to deploy them to the target. At present, Tzunami Deployer supports all default SharePoint web parts. Please contact our support team if you would like to inquire about support for any custom web parts. When we are satisfied with our structure, we move on and Deployer begins reading the selected content into our Deployer project. Deployer is able to read all necessary content from the SharePoint server, including custom and global templates. Once Deployer is done loading, we can explore the hierarchy of the SharePoint content. Similar to the look and feel of Windows Explorer, Deployer displays the content from the source with a tree view on the left and with a list view on the right. This allows us to easily browse through our content and understand our content structure. As you can see, our site collection has been fully loaded into the project with its content. Since this is a team site, it contains a discussion, a links list, an announcements list, some document libraries, and so on. To connect to our target SharePoint 2010, we use the same method as we did for loading the source. we right-click the target panel and choose Connect to SharePoint. The same connection wizard appears to guide us through the process of loading the target. We choose the necessary web application, sites, lists, and items and load them into the project. We can right-click on another site that has not yet been loaded and select Reload Item. The loading wizard appears again to guide us through the reload process. Now that both our source and target are loaded into our project, we begin our deploy phase and start performing our virtual migration. To deploy content from our source, SharePoint 2007, to our target, SharePoint 2010, we can use several methods. The first and easiest of which is to drag and drop our selected content to the desired destination in the target. We'll select our Tzunami site collection from the source and drag it to our demo site collection in the target. The deploy wizard appears to guide us through the process of deploying the selected items to SharePoint 2010. In the first step, we choose if we would like to deploy the files along with their security. Choosing to deploy the items without their security settings will make the deployment process faster. We'll deploy a basic security structure for the purposes of this demonstration. We start by specifying the global settings. Here we can decide how Deployer will name files with duplicate file names. We can also choose the specific number of versions to be deployed. Under the List tab, we are able to control some of the list settings in SharePoint, such as supporting major and minor versions and attachments. In the Define Deployment Structure panel, we have the ability to control the hierarchy of our deployment, including site and list templates, folders, and so on. The deployer automatically suggests how to deploy the items from SharePoint 2007 to the corresponding SharePoint 2010 items. We first decide how to migrate our main site. We can choose a site template from the drop-down menu, which has all of the default SharePoint site templates, as well as the option to use custom templates. For example, we choose the pre-created custom template for our site and move on to determine the structure below it. The calendar will be migrated using the existing calendar. Our case tracking list will be migrated as a new issue tracking list. We can migrate our company documents document library as an existing shared documents library. Human resources will be migrated as a subsite, and our Tzunami custom list will be migrated as a new custom list. Deployer also gives us the option to migrate our content with or without the hierarchy structure. If we choose flat deploy, the items are all migrated on the same level and the hierarchy is not deployed. We'll now perform the security mapping, which consists of three main steps: groups mapping, entities mapping, and role mapping. We'll start with the groups mapping. In the left panel, all source groups that are relevant to the items deployed will appear. In the right panel, there will be a list with all the target groups which are relevant to the site we have chosen to deploy into. The bottom panel consists of pairs of source groups and target groups that have been automatically mapped by Deployer. We have the ability to select our own mappings using the Map button. For example, we'll select the support team group in the source and select Create New Group in the target and click Map. This will create a new group in the target bearing the same name. In the entities mapping step, you can map each source user or group to a target user or group. For example, since most of the users have already been mapped, we'll select the two remaining users, Brian and Peter, and map them to a group. Demo members. Mapping a source entity to a target entity means that the target entity will receive the same permissions that the source entity had. In the final step of the security mapping, we'll map source roles to target roles. As you can see, the deployer automatically maps the corresponding roles. The deployer also gives us the option to add or remove different roles from the drop-down menu in the target panel. Now we'll perform the property mapping step. On the left, Deployer displays a list of properties that exist in the documents from our source, SharePoint 2007. And on the right, we can view a list of properties that are available for us from the target, SharePoint 2010. Once again, Deployer automatically suggests some of the basic mappings. Deployer enables us to map any remaining properties according to our own specifications. We select the property from the source list and the matching property from the target list and click Map. In some of the property mapping screens, a link will appear at the top to notify us when the target has fewer properties than the source. This will tell Deployer to add any of the missing properties we select. We'll choose to maintain the callback number and city properties and bring these properties and their corresponding values over to our target. Now that we have finished mapping our properties, we need to map the associated values of these properties. Once again, the Deployer intuitively maps values in the source to target values with the same name. For example, Jody, John, and Marcy have already been mapped. As we did for the property mapping, we can select our own value mappings using the Map button. We are now ready to deploy. During this phase, Deployer applies all of the deployment settings and mappings that we have already selected. When the deployment is finished, we can open the Deployer reports. These reports allow us to view any errors and warnings that may have occurred during the virtual deployment. This enables us to make any modifications prior to the commit phase, such as changing an exceedingly long URL path or enabling a blocked extension. In our example, we have one insignificant warning regarding the link item that we've deployed. This is caused due to SharePoint's naming conventions, which the tool is already designed to handle. We are now able to take a look at the results of the deployment. Within Deployer, we can view the properties in the target panel and confirm that the metadata associated with the items which we plan to migrate to SharePoint are all preserved according to our specifications. Now, assuming that we're satisfied with the migration, we'll perform the changes to SharePoint 2010. By committing our project, we tell Deployer to perform all the changes that we made virtually and write these changes to SharePoint 2010. During the commit, the actual content migration physically copies the source items to the target library, list, or folder on the SharePoint site, while updating their metadata properties according to the Tzunami Deployer project definitions. Under the View tab, we can view the commit report to see what was committed to SharePoint and view any warnings or errors that might have occurred when writing the selected content to SharePoint. Once the commit has finished, we'll right-click the new site and choose Open in order to open it in SharePoint via Internet Explorer. We can take a look at all the site content and see that the migration was successful. This concludes our Tzunami Deployer demonstration for the migration of content from SharePoint 2007 to SharePoint 2010. We thank you for your time and welcome you to visit our website in order to download an evaluation version of Tzunami Deployer for SharePoint 2007 and learn more about the Tzunami family of products.